Hello students, I welcome you all in the next session of your micro machining and nano fabrication process. In this process today we are going to study micro ultrasonic machining process, micro USM process. Introduction about micro USM process. You have already studied USM process in your third year manufacturing process to what is ultrasonic machining process. You already know about basics of ultrasonic machining process, but today we will discuss little bit different than your ultrasonic micro machining process. Okay, so introduction. In your introduction, this micro machining process is most important. In case of your micro machining process, there are different processes are available according to the requirement of the customer. Companies starts fulfilling their requirement by using various techniques. So companies will start improving their conventional techniques by using various ways. So this is your important micro machining technique, which is your ultrasonic micro ultrasonic machining technique. So this micro ultrasonic machining technique is used for not only manufacturing or machining of a micro components, but it is also useful for fabricating high aspect ratio 3D micro features. Means this process is useful for manufacturing plus fabricating purpose also. So where we are using this micro ultrasonic machining process? Am I audible to you? Please leave a message in chat box if yes or no. Okay, thank you, Aniket. Thank you, Neha. Okay, now this micro ultrasonic machining process is used for two different types of a material. It is used for harder and stronger materials like titanium and its alloys, nickel alloys, and it is also useful for, means this machining process is also carried out on brittle materials like ceramic, glass, quartz, composite material, precise stones. Means this process is useful for all kinds of materials because we are using ultrasonic machining process. So next is your fabricating micro holes, where we are using this micro ultrasonic machining process to create micro holes. Its diameter is around 5 micrometer. Tubes can be manufactured by using micro ultrasonic machining process, which is used in integrated circuit board, MEMS. Okay. These are the different applications where you can use micro ultrasonic machining process. Biomedical is one of the application, grids for manufacturing of grids. Then fluidic filters, fluid injection nozzles can be manufactured with the help of this process also. Inkjet printer nozzles, optical apertures, then micro pipettes, high pressure orifice and pneumatic sensors can be manufactured with the help of this ultra microsonic machining process. Okay, this is the introduction part. What kind of a material and which process is useful for your micro machining process. Now next slide represents your basic figure of a micro ultrasonic machining process. It is similar to your ultrasonic machining process. Now what are the basic elements of your micro ultrasonic machining process? Workpiece is clamped over the fixture. You can observe in this figure. This is hash portion represents your workpiece, which is clamped over the fixture, and fixture is placed inside the container. Inside this container. Next, this portion represents slurry. Slurry is provided with the help of the nozzle, and slurry is provided between your workpiece and the tool. This portion, vertical portion, represents your micro tool, which is clamped into the tool holder. And tool holder is connected to the transducer, which provides the frequency around 20 to 40 kilohertz. And slurry outlet is also provided. In your slurry, we are providing abrasive particles. As we know, abrasive particles are available in different size and shape. Abrasive particles, different sizes and shape means it is available in coarse, medium, fine, very fine. This is the size of your abrasive particles. And what kind of abrasive we are using? Al2O3, aluminium oxide, silicon carbide, boron carbide. These are the aluminiums, these are the abrasives which is used in a slurry to carry out the cutting action, because we are providing linear motion to the tool holder, plus slurry is provided between your tool and the workpiece. So this is the basic figure of your ultrasonic machining process. So we are providing, according to the requirement, we are providing linear motion to the tool holder plus rotary motion to the tool holder to carry out the machining operation. Now, next slide represents mechanism of a material remove. Then how the material is removed by using ultrasonic machining process, micro ultrasonic machining process. Basic difference between your ultrasonic machining process and micro ultrasonic machining process is we are manufacturing micro component. In case of your micro ultrasonic machining process, okay, this is the basic difference. So first is your tool fabrication. Fabrication of a tool plays important role. Means your tool, this tool is connected to the tool holder, or this is also called as a horn. Okay, so connecting your tool in case of your micro USM. Now here it is mentioned micro USM and macro. Macro USM means your conventional USM. In case of your conventional USM process, tool is fabricated. This tool is fabricated to your tool holder or another system with the help of the soldering or brazing action. Okay, but in case of your micro ultrasonic machining process, this tool is directly clamped into the tool holder or a horn. So clamping of a tool or fabrication of a tool in tool holder plays important role. Why it plays important role? Because we need accurate, precise component, because component is very small. It is micro component. So fabricating of a tool plays important role. So micro USM, the coaxial micro tool, is clamped into the tool holder and it manufactures the different shapes. What kind of a shapes can be manufactured by using micro USM? Polygonal shape, spiral shape, or cylindrical shape holes, small size, nanometer size holes can be manufactured by using this micro ultrasonic micro machining process. So it is important to clamp your tool properly, coaxially, into the tool holder. So micro tool with diameter as low as 3 micrometers can be fabricated. So that is the important point, to clamp your tool into the tool holder. So this is your first point in case of your mechanism of a material removal. Then second point, what this second point represents. Now first point we have covered here, clamping of a tool into the tool holder. Now this tool holder is connected to the next element here, to the transducer, which is known as a piezoelectric or magnetostative transducer. What is the main function of using this piezoelectric or a magnetostative transducer is, which provides or which converts the low frequency signal into the high frequency signals. Low frequency signal into the high frequency signal. What is the main function? Converting this signal to provide the linear motion, which is mentioned in this figure by this arrow. Means we are providing linear motion to this tool by using transducer to carry out the machining operation. So it is done with the help of the piezoelectric transducer. And its range is around 20 kilohertz. And when we are providing linear motion to the tool by using transducer will transmit this motion to the tool holder will transmit this linear motion to the tool. And linear motion is provided and it will carry out the machining operation. Due to this linear motion, material is removed in the form of a small chips or granules. It is also possible to provide the rotary motion to the tool with the help of the transducer, but it is depending on the requirement. So according to the requirement, provide linear as well as rotary motion to your tool to manufacture your product. This is your second element. And what is the third element? Third element is the abrasive slurry. Abrasive slurry. What kind of abrasive slurry used in this? Now, as we know, now again go to the figure. This small gap, narrow gap is provided between your tool and the workpiece. Why this gap is provided? Because we are providing slurry between your tool and the workpiece. And in your slurry, we are providing or we are adding this silicon carbide, boron, nitride, aluminium oxide, alumina or diamond dust. These are the abrasive particles which is mixed into the carrier material, which is known as abrasive slurry. And this abrasive slurry is provided on your workpiece surface with the help of the nozzle. And this abrasive particles carries the cutting edges. As we know, single point cutting tool is having single cutting edge. Abrasive particles which is carrying the cutting edges to remove the material. So when we are providing this abrasive slurry, nozzles are used and it is provided with higher pressure, and we are also providing linear motion to the tool. And linear motion to the tool, and due to this linear motion this abrasive particle strikes to the workpiece surface and it removes the material in the form of a small particles. So main function of abrasive slurry and the tool is to remove the material in the form of a chips. The cyclic and ultrasonic linear motion of a tool gives downward stroke to the abrasive particles and it is removed in the form of a tiny particles. And last part of your mechanism of a material remove rate is USM, means ultrasonic machining process can be done by using two different ways. As we know, when the tool holder is connected to the tool holder is connected to the transducer, it is providing linear plus rotary motion, but it is also possible to provide the vibratory motion to your workpiece. So what is your first process? First is, one is by vibrating the micro tool, means we are providing vibratory motion to the tool. This is your first method. And second method is vibrating your workpiece itself. This is your second method. By providing vibratory motion to your workpiece also, it is also possible to remove the material in the form of a small chips. But we have to achieve the accuracy and precision or dimensions, exact dimensions. But how to achieve the accuracy, precision, exact dimensions, and how to remove larger amount of a material? So it depends on frequency and amplitude of vibration, load applied to the tool, rotary motion if it has been implemented on a tool head or a workpiece, type of abrasive particles and liquid. These are the main parameters which plays important role to remove the larger amount of a material and to get accuracy and precision. And also it is depending on the size of a component. What is the size of a component? What is the size of an abrasive particle? If you are providing fine abrasive particle into the slurry, then it will remove the smaller amount of material. Coarse size of abrasive particles, if you are providing, then it will remove larger amount of a material from your workpiece surface. So concentration and flow rate of a slurry, means we are providing slurry with the help of a nozzle. So nozzle size plays important role. If it is smaller, then high pressure slurry is provided to the workpiece surface and it removes the larger amount of a material. And last parameter, geometry and thickness of a workpiece surface, it also affect the accuracy and precision of manufacturing of your product. Okay, this is the main parameters of your material remove mechanism of micro ultrasonic machining process. In the next slide, what are the opportunities of micro ultrasonic machining process and why it is important? So as we discuss in our first slide in introduction, this process, micro ultrasonic machining process, it is necessary or it is providing low frequency signal, it is converting low frequency signal into the high frequency signal with the help of the transducer. So it does not depend on the material, workpiece material, which kind of a material we are manufacturing. So fabricate micro features both on electrically conductive and non-conductive materials, means it is suitable for all kind of a material. It may be a conductive, electrically conductive, or non-conductive materials. Then what are the applications? It is applicable in the field of medical, electronics, aerospace. But where it is applicable? USM, micro USM, it is applicable to create micro slots, micro holes, 3D cavities can be manufactured in medical, electronics, and aerospace industries. Then what is the size of a micro slots, micro holes, 3D cavities? Size of a micro holes is around 20 micrometers diameter to 50 micrometer depth. And it is also possible to manufacture silicon and quartz component by using micro USM process. As I told you, this process is not only used for manufacturing purpose, but this is useful for fabricating purpose also. The combination of ultrasonic vibrations as well as rotational leads to sliding. As we discuss in working, we are providing linear plus rotary motion. Due to this rotary motion, sliding action of your tool will take place with your workpiece, and it will remove larger amount of a material, and it is less time consuming as compared to the when we are providing linear motion. So drilling holes up to 20 microns, it is also possible. Example is soda lime glass in case of your micro USM process. Then it is also possible to manufacture components of micro heat exchangers, micro sensors can be manufactured, 3D micro features on silicon, polymer, ceramics, and glass that can readily be applicable for micro electrochemical systems, means micro USM system is useful for MEMS, micro electromechanical systems, to manufacturing of MEMS components. What are the challenges of your micro ultrasonic machining process? Challenges, as we discuss, your ultrasonic machining, conventional ultrasonic machining process and micro ultrasonic machining process, difference is we are using micro tool in case of your micro ultrasonic machining process to manufacture micro components or nano components. But fabrication of a tool plays important role. So skilled operator is required, plus fabrication of a tool to the proper location. It should be coaxial, so it will manufacture accurate and precise component which may not deteriorate the accuracy and performance of a process making micro tools with traditional process. So it is important also to manufacture your micro tool. It is also plays important role. This is also the one of the challenge, fabrication of a micro tool into the tool holder, that is also the challenge. Then manufacturing of a micro tool, that is also the challenge for your micro USM. But it is not possible by using traditional process, means it is not possible by using traditional process means micro tools cannot be manufactured by using traditional process accurately, precisely. So it can be manufactured or prepared by using WEDG, wire electric discharge machining process. These are the different processes. Non-conventional machining processes are useful to create your micro tools. These are the challenges of your micro ultrasonic machining process, fabrication and manufacturing of a tool. What are the applications of a micro ultrasonic machining process in micro engineering? First, making small holes in helicopter power transmission shaft and gears, fabrication of a 3D micro air turbines. This is the application of mechanical application of your micro USM. Then machining of a watch bearings, small gears. Wrist watch is one of the example where the small gears, small bearings can be manufactured with the help of the micro USM process. Third, generation of a high aspect ratio micro holes on a silicon and glass wafer for pressure and flow sensors. Sensors can be manufactured, and in last slide, I already told you micro channels for bio MEMS. MEMS components can be manufactured. Biomedical plus electronics industries are using this micro ultrasonic machining process. Thank you everyone. I hope you understood this topic, today's topic, micro ultrasonic machining process. If you have any doubt, please ask question. Please leave a message in chat box.